Hi, I'm Jamila Musayeva, an international social etiquette consultant and the author of two books, Etiquette, The Least You Need to Know and Afternoon Tea Etiquette. For all my old viewers and subscribers, welcome back to the channel. For all the new ones, please make sure that you subscribe. In this channel, every month, twice, I am sharing entertaining, hopefully, and educational videos about soft skills, self-development, and etiquette. In today's video, we're going to be looking at the images of state officials and world politicians and observing where they broke the etiquette rules. In other words, we're going to look at their faux pas taken in regards to etiquette. Faux pas is a French word which literally means wrong step, and it's actually a word that's now incorporated into English vocabulary and literally means anywhere or anytime a wrong step is taken. So we're gonna look at seven images where world politicians have committed faux pas. So the first picture we're looking at is Obama greeting the Japanese emperor in 2009. Actually, this image at the time caused a lot of talk in US press, and that's because Obama, the US president, was bowing to Japanese emperor. So why this picture is so talked about is because Obama is going for a handshake, so he's greeting the Japanese emperor with a handshake, but then he's also bowing. As you already know, etiquette is a very culturally sensitive topic, and the greeting forms differs from country to country, from culture to culture. There is no one right way of greeting someone. However, we have taken sort of a standard of the Western world, and we apply that standard of greeting, which is a handshake, in all business or political settings. So we say a formal greetings in all those sorts of situations is going for a handshake. So here in this case, the Japanese emperor is giving his hand, extending his hand for a handshake, and Obama is taking his hand and shaking his hand, meanwhile bowing to him. It's admirable that Obama is trying to show respect and trying to show that he is aware of the Japanese way of greeting, so bowing in this case, but he's not doing it completely one way. So he's actually mixing the two greeting forms in one, which is not right. If we were to look at a traditional way of bowing, there would be no physical contact between Obama and the Japanese emperor. What would happen is their hands would be close like that, their fingertips together, and held by their sides at a thigh level. Again, with their backs bent down to bow. There will be no eye contact in that case. The more trickier part here would be who would be bowing more or lower. So usually the idea is that whoever needs to pay more respect would be bowing lower. If we're looking at the picture, we cannot say that this has caused some kind of a discomfort or maybe contempt on the part of Japanese emperor. On the other hand, I would say he looks like he appreciated this gesture because you can see that genuine smile on his face, and it's obvious that he has appreciated this gesture made by Obama to show respect to Japanese culture. But in this case, what I think would cause the confusion is that he should either just bowed or he should have gone for a handshake, but not mixing the two together in one greeting. The second image we're going to be looking at, it actually has to do, there are a lot of pictures of US officials patting the Queen on her back. And you could observe how a lot of US leaders are patting other leaders on their back when they're greeting them. I think it's a very American way of greeting people, showing a little bit of informality in a relationship. But generally speaking, one should not pat Queen's back. And not just the Queen's, I would go to say that in a formal setting, you shouldn't be patting anyone's back. But if we were to compare the two images, one is the image of Michelle Obama and the other is of Donald Trump. Both of them are patting the Queen. Michelle Obama's hand is a little bit higher on the back of the Queen, whereas Donald's hand is actually on the lower part of the Queen's back. Generally speaking, the lower the touch on the back, the more intimate it's deemed to be. So patting a Queen on the lower back is definitely inappropriate. Either way, patting is not a good idea in a formal setting, but patting on the lower part of the back is even worse. The third image that we're going to be looking at is of someone that is so talked about in today's media, and that is Meghan Markle, particularly in the picture where they're announcing their engagement with Harry. If you're looking at this picture, you can see that Meghan Markle is wearing a beautiful green dress. She has closed-toe shoes, she has a trench coat, but she's not wearing any pantyhose. general rule is that for this kind of official pictures and announcements, a person who is either joining the royal family or is a member of a royal family has to wear pantyhose. This is just not a whimsical desire of someone who wants to attack Meghan Markle, but rather it's what is accepted by royal families around the world. So if you look at the picture of engagement announcements from other European family members, you'll see that either the royal or the person who's joining the royal family is wearing a pantyhose. So when one is accepting this new role, so joining a royal family, one should also follow the rules of dress code as well. And this doesn't only apply in terms of, you know, marrying a royal family, but also if you think about it, when you're joining a company, you have a dress code and you know what you're supposed to wear and not to wear. And if you want to be a part of the company, you have to make sure that you follow these rules. Again, it applies not only to royals, but also to our work and life in general. The image that we're going to be looking at, but before we look at, I just want to say that the First Lady of France, Brigitte Macron, loves wearing dresses above her knee. Generally speaking, this is not acceptable for such a formal role of being the First Lady of a country. Her dress should be below her knees, but let's just think that this is her style and she prefers to do that and she can do whatever she wants to. But in her state visit to Egypt, alongside her husband, Emmanuel Macron, she's wearing above the knee red dress. Knowing that Egypt is a predominantly Muslim country, it is showing a lot of disrespect towards the host of the country. Again, here the dilemma might be, you know, if she is the host, let's say the Egyptian delegation is visiting France, it is somewhat more acceptable for her to wear a dress that's above her knees because she's in her country and it's acceptable in France. But in this picture, she's actually the guest to Egypt. So she's visiting, the French delegation is visiting Egypt, and as such, she needed to respect the rules. Knowing that Egypt is predominantly a Muslim country, she had to opt for a dress that would be below her knees to show that she understands the culture that she's visiting, to pay respect to the country that she's visiting. Generally speaking, the rule is that as a guest, you have to obey, you have to follow the rules of the host. You have to play it by their playbook, by their rule book. So say you're going to someone's home and it's customary there to take off your shoes before entering the house. You would do that when entering their home, even if that's not the rule in your own house. Similarly, when you apply this idea into more state official visits, you do the same. As a guest country in someone else's country, you'd play by the rule book of that country. If they dress more modestly, you would do that too. If, for example, it's not acceptable to wear a certain color, you wouldn't wear it. No matter what you do in your own country, when you're visiting, forget about your own rules and make sure that you respect the rules of the country that you're visiting. Continuing on the topic of a dress code, we're going to look at image number 5. Here we have a picture of an event. We can see that they're all very well dressed up. So there is this royal family of Netherlands and there's a delegation from Argentina. You see the First Lady of Argentina who's wearing a beautiful dress, but there's something wrong with it. If you look at the picture, you can tell based on what the men are wearing, they have white bow ties and white vests, so you can tell it's a white tie event. For those of you that are unfamiliar with dress codes, white tie event is the most formal event, and actually very few people get invited to white tie, only maybe state officials and some celebrities to certain occasions. So it's the most formal of all events, and therefore the white tie dress code is the most formal. In this situation, for the ladies, it's required that their dresses cover their shoulders. So their shoulders should not be open. Unlike with a black tie event, they can opt for an open décolleté. Here, they have to cover their shoulders. In this case, you can tell if you look at the other participants of this white tie event, they're all wearing dresses that cover their shoulders, except for the First Lady of Argentina. She looks remarkable, but she's not really suitable for the dress code. The final image that we're going to be looking at today is of my favorite royal, Queen Rania. This is an old image from 1999 and she is posing alongside Queen Elizabeth, and you can tell that she's holding her bag in her right arm, whereas Queen Elizabeth is holding her bag in her left arm. Now, if we look at the recent pictures of Queen Rania, you can see how she's now holding her bags in her left arm, therefore leaving her right arm accessible for handshake if so is required. There is a reason why Queen always puts her back on her left arm, therefore leaving her right arm accessible at any time for a handshake, for a greeting. This etiquette rule doesn't only apply to royals, monarchs, or state officials. It's actually very good to remember when you're out socializing at a networking event, at a conference, when you're meeting constantly people, make sure that you transfer your back into your left arm, therefore leaving your right hand accessible for a handshake when you need to do one. Or, for example, you picked up a drink, make sure you transfer it to your left hand so your right hand is always empty and you can always extend it quickly for a greeting. Thank you very much for watching this video until the very end. I do hope that you liked this video and maybe made some conclusions or discovered something new about etiquette. Please let me know down in the comment section below if you would like to see more of a similar content, and I'll be more than happy to shoot new videos for you. Thank you, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.